food prep Sunday. I actually enjoyed my food prep because it's kind of giving me a little time to get away from everything and just kind of focus on one thing and plan the rest of my week how it's going to go. Food prep is a good way to either start your week with success or start your week with failing and kind of always catching up, because if you have the food in front of you, you'll eat it. But sometimes people fail to prepare. It's like preparing to fail, famous quote. So make sure you guys prepare your food, have at least 3 meals ready so that you can just grab and go and not think about it. So what I like to do for food prep is this.
Yeah, 3 packs of ground turkey. We use 93.7, a little bit higher fat because we use high fat, no carbs in here. Okay, so high fat, no carbs, we throw some almonds in there. We got some jasmine rice cooking. We got slow cooked chicken with a little bit of barbecue and beer. Cooking here for 8 hours. And also another source of carbs is going to be beans. I change up the beans types every week so kind of don't get bored. And it's a great source of fiber, great source to keep your digestive system in check, you know, because if you eat high protein diet and you don't eat enough fiber, you're going to be screwed, you're not going to have a good time. So that's pretty much it. And throughout the week, you know, this is going to get into my fridge, you know. Everything is healthy, there's nothing, no crap here, you know, because if you keep crap in the fridge, you most likely eat it. So we got to try to avoid keeping crap in the fridge and just keep coffee foods. Alright, so I'm gonna prep my food and get this week started with success.
Alright, so the food's already cooked. I'm gonna show you how I divide my carbs and proteins into a container of vegetables and kind of give you an idea of how to kind of, if you don't know how to count macros, where to start. Okay, so for a meal, I suggest you guys do 5 ounces of your meat, 5 ounces of your carb, and then 3 ounces of your vegetable, alright? Vegetables can be flexible. You can add a little bit more if you want to. If you're more hungry, add more. If you're less, you have less appetite, add less, okay? But you still want at least 2 or 3 servings of vegetables a day. All right, so let me show you how it's done, right? So first, let's see if this goes. Okay, so first thing you guys gotta do is make sure you get a measuring tool. This is the key, guys. You can't just eyeball it. Eyeball it will get you half-assed results, right? But if you know exactly what you're getting, you'll be more, you'll know what to change. So first week, start off with is just 5 ounces of each, about 6 meals, okay? 6 meals. For me, I do 8 meals. But 5 ounces of meat, 5 ounces of carb. So I'm gonna do 2 ounces of beans and 3 ounces of rice. Okay, so that equals 5 ounces altogether of carbs. All right, so let's do this. So you're gonna take, put in ounces, just like this, all right? And we add 5 ounces of meat to each meal, all right? There we go. That's for male, guys. I'm talking about male for the males right now. And I'll show you exactly for females what it looks like too, because I'm gonna make my wife's meal too. So 5 ounces of this, then you'll go get a spoon. You go 2 ounces of this. There you go. And then you're gonna go 3 ounces of rice. Okay, so that's protein, carbs are in. Now we do vegetables. So I use frozen vegetables because vegetables are just pain in the ass to cook and they do not stay fresh for a long time, so I just use frozen ones. Yeah, open. So then you, there you go, 2 ounces of vegetables. So, hello wifey.
Hello.
So that's my meal right there. Easy, and that's about it. I know exactly what's going into my body. So if you guys just start off with that meal, you know, go for a week or two. If you have no fat loss, minus 1 gram of carb and 1 gram of protein away from your diet, and then try it again or add some more cardio to your diet. So that's for males. For females, I'm gonna make a meal for my wife. So for her, she's gonna get 3 ounces of meat or protein source. So it doesn't matter if it's turkey, chicken, whatever it is. She'll get 3 ounces. She's gonna get 1.5 ounces of beans, and then 1.5 ounces of rice. So hers are just a little bit less, because she doesn't eat as much calories. All right, and then she'll get a little bit more vegetable to keep her full. There you go. And that's her meal. Very simple, guys. Start with that. You know, females, that's where you start up. And same thing, adjust, you know, to your diet. If you see no fat loss in those 6 meals, you know, a day, then, you know, lower it down. If you guys don't have time for 6 meals, make those meals double to 6 ounces of 6 ounces of meat, 6 ounces of carbs, and then eat 3 meals. Okay, for guys, you use 10 and 10. All right, guys, so hopefully that helped. All right, guys. So it's about 5:15 a.m. Headed to the gym for my fasted cardio. Do you have to do fasted cardio? No, you can do whatever cardio you want to do. I do fasted cardio because I don't feel like eating right now, and then coming home and then eating again. So I'm doing my cardio, no food. Just a slow, steady cardio right now. You know, I'm not trying to burn down any muscle right now, so I'm just trying to get some cardio and just burn a little bit of calories. That's about it. Calories in, calories out right now. When the fat starts to get a little bit stubborn and stops coming down, I will start manipulating my cardio and start doing a little bit of HIIT cardio and things like that to make the fat loss a little bit faster. But right now it's coming down pretty easy. As you guys seen, it came down already 6 pounds. And so I'm on the right track. I don't have to do any HIIT cardio right now, but eventually I will start throwing more HIIT cardio and things like that. But right now it's pretty easy going, just fast cardio and just get up early. Now just water, glutamine, and still no BCAAs because not needed right now. So I only try to use the least supplement. These supplements as possible. Okay, so right now I'm not eating, so then I use it. Alright, guys. Alright, guys. So, second week of the diet, more visible abs. As you guys noticed, down already 6 pounds. So, good progress. Nothing dramatic, just 3 days of cardio and a little bit adjusted carbs. Still eating 250 300 grams of carbs, which is perfect. And making some good progress. No supplements added yet for fat burners or anything like that. Just L-carnitine. That's it. Let's keep this going for week 3. Let's get it.
Alright, so it's 6 a.m. Getting to work, trying to train my clients. Today's gonna be a long day. From 6 a.m. all the way to 7:30. Every single hour, double clients. Let's do this.
Alright, guys, that's a wrap. So that's Monday. Like I said, long day. Started to work at 6 a.m. Now it's about 7:30. Just got finished with all my clients. You know, every single hour, double clients. Long day, but I love what I do. So it makes the job very easy. The day goes by very fast. I enjoy touching cool clients because every single client I have, they are different. You know, everybody's bringing something different to the table. But one thing they do bring is hard work ethic. You know, every single client gives it best. Their best effort most days, and I appreciate the most, you know. And yeah, even though it's 6 a.m. to 7:30, takes a lot of sacrifice for my time. That means I gotta be here the whole time, training, focusing, training them. But that's part of it, you know. Just like
you know, in fitness, you want to be successful in fitness, you gotta sacrifice something. You know, you gotta sacrifice a little bit of flavor in food for the result. You know, you gotta sacrifice the time of prep food, you know, for the result you want. You gotta sacrifice in anything, you know, in a relationship. You gotta sacrifice your selfishness, you know, to have a good relationship. You gotta sacrifice, you know, time to give the person your all to have a great relationship, you know what I mean? So anything in life takes sacrifice. That's what I'm learning. That's one thing that gym has taught me is whatever you put in, you get out. You know, you put in 100%, you get back 100%. You know, you put in 80%, you get back 80%. Same thing in life, you know, same thing in business, same thing in relationship. Can you say that our relationship work out like that? No. Some people put 100% in the relationship and the partner does not agree. But if you find a great partner like I do, you know, you give her 100%, she gives you back 100%. You know, same thing with business. The more you put in, the more you get out. It's simple as that. Fitness is the same thing, okay? So there's a lot I learned about fitness, you know. Dedication, that you gotta be committed to your goals. You can't expect to, you know, as a business owner, you can't expect to get up at 11 a.m., go to work for 5 hours, and be successful. Not in the beginning, not at the start. At the start, you gotta hustle. You gotta put in all your effort into it in order to be successful. Same thing in fitness. You gotta work way, way harder in the beginning than the person that's more advanced than you. Okay, you gotta work way more harder because you have a lot to learn, a lot to build. So that's the day. Not a great thing about it. Day's over. I go home. I see my wife. She probably has a dinner ready. You know, go home, hang out with her, update some programs that I'm writing down, and watch a movie, relax with her, and that's the night. All right, guys. Live your life. Enjoy what you do. You know, if you are one of those people that go to work and you hate the job, find something else. You know, something else that you could make money, but enjoy it. So, good night.
All right, guys. So, often a question I get asked is, what's a good pre-workout meal? First of all, it depends on the person. You know, what works better for you? Are you the person that runs better on carbohydrates during training, or are you the person that runs better on fats during training? So you gotta figure out that first. For me personally, I run better on carbohydrates and get better pumps. I could last longer through the workout without fatiguing. So for me, my pre-workout meal today is, I got 3 packets of Fit Oats, I think they call it. So it's 100 calorie oatmeal packages. So I have 3 of them in here, a little bit of water and cinnamon. And I have 5 ounces of ground turkey with a little bit of hot sauce. The reason I like to use hot sauce pre-workout is hot sauce, soy sauce, all kinds of sauces that have a lot of sodium in it, because you have great pumps during the workout, you know. So the blood, the water, the salt attracts water, so the water goes to your muscle, and you get better pumps during training. So that's my pre-workout. If you're more sensitive or you don't run great on carbs, you get tired when you eat carbs, stick to fat. So maybe like ground turkey with coconut oil, and that's about it.
All right, Sunday, we're gonna go crush some delts and bicep with my wife. We're also gonna do 15 minutes of cardio, so we're gonna keep that 15 minutes a day cardio. Or if we skip a day, that means it's 30 next time. If you skip 2 days, it's 45. So you're just gonna make sure you get 15 minutes a day, stair stepper, and then like crush on shoulders or your delts. It's just lateral movements, no presses, because I did triceps yesterday. And biceps, and I'm gonna run through a bicep routine with you guys that I do, and I'll go from there. But Sunday, yes, we train on Sunday because tomorrow is my day off, because it's really, really busy day, and Mondays are the most busy days for me when it comes to clients, so I don't have time to train. Like, literally, I'm there from 6 a.m. to about 7:30. So by the time I'm done with the clients, I'm just exhausted to train, get home, so have sex with my wife.
Oh gosh.
And go to sleep.
forward. Stay long. Stop pushing.
I'm here. Step away from the window and go back to sleep. Safe from pain and truth and choice and the poison devils. See, they don't give a fuck about you like I do.
Place where I start working. First job, Charlie Brown's. And yours too, right, Olga?
Yeah.
With dinner. Look at this cutie. He's just sitting there, waiting to order. With his spoon, he's ready to eat.
Ready for the basket.
Drop?
some dinner, about 9 ounces of filet mignon, baked potato, some Bernays sauce, just a little bit. So you guys go out and eat potatoes, okay? Just an example. Michael? What are you eating, Michael?
Mashed potatoes.
You eating mashed potatoes?